Hello guys, this is Paraleo, and yes, Age of Empires 3 fan. I'm a fan of the original of the original game, because it was, the campaigns were definitely harder than this one. But enough about that. Today they released a new civilization. I read about it. It's actually very cool. If you wanna see the overview video, check out the description. It's made by the developers, and nobody can make it better than the developers, okay? But in this vid, I wanna showcase actually some ways to cut out the gaming time, because yeah, you don't have to actually play for 3 days. Yeah, let me just get back. So you can actually win it for free if you complete 50 challenges in Age of Empires 3 Definitive Edition. Okay, this is the list. They're not tough. You can complete them in multiplayer, you can complete them in skirmish versus the AI. It doesn't matter the difficulty. Just have to put in the time. I guess they're trying to do something like, those who don't have patience can buy the DLC. Those who do have patience can play some skirmish. Maybe they fall in love with the game. I think that's the marketing bit about it. And I understand there will be an expansion with African civilization later this year. Alright, so you can only unlock one challenge at a time. I already did two. Actually, I played the game fully and I won it for the first one. A skirmish game. It wasn't on very hard or something like that. And for this one, because I didn't have the time, after I completed the request, I saved and I got out. And the challenge was active, so you don't have to win that game in which you solve the challenge. And now I want to see if my hunch is right. So for the third one, I have to build 3 docks in a single skirmish multiplayer game. That means in the same match you have to build 3 docks. And I will take the save from the other thing and see. Begin what? Let's load it. Yes, I actually played the main campaign at release. I don't remember when it was, in 15th October, something like that. I played the first 34 missions already, and they are recorded, but because the AI was definitely weaker than in the original, I actually didn't post. Well, maybe I will, because I think they make the AI easier in purpose to discourage the new players. Now, this is my save. I played with the French. It's on standard difficulty, as I said. Okay, let's build 3 docks. I already have one, but I don't think this one counts. So let's see.
Votre ordre? Bon, très bien, je le ferai. Oui, je le ferai.
I don't actually care. Let's build 3.
Maçon. Maçon. Prêt.
Yeah, I'm gonna
oui, je le ferai. Maçon.
That's why I didn't look, because I had one of these guys over here. So I was sure I wasn't getting the beating. Alright. I love the graphics though. They are 1 million times better than in the original. Actually, I checked them at release. So this is very good. Very, a big difference. Okay, we got 3. Let's save. Just because maybe I want to use the save in another one. In another challenge, if it fits. Okay, let's get out. Let's see if it... I know, I was the best. Let's check it out. So it completed. Yeah, so they didn't make it too hard, I guess. But you can only complete 3 challenges a day. Now, earn the most coin out of all players in a single skirmish multiplayer. Now for this one, I don't know if you have to finish the game or you just have to lead at some point. Yeah, so call militia, it's easy basically. It's easy to do, you don't even have to finish the match. The same, so basically you do this, you save, you get out, you restart the game. After you see that you completed this one, you restart the game and research for upgrades. Yeah, it's actually not required to play 3, but if you are a player who likes to play every day and only this game, by all means play 3 games a day. It will be fun, but if you don't have time, just try to cut some corners, because they won't mind. If they would wanted you to play 3 games, they would have made it obvious. Yeah. Okay, guys, that was all I wanted to say. Yeah. Have fun. Actually, the DLC is 5 euros in my region, so for you, might be 5 bucks or something, or the equivalent. Basically, it's the lowest amount you can pay for a released DLC, right? It's 5 euros, it's the minimum. Alright guys, thanks for watching, and maybe I'll upload the whole series, because I have it on my hard drive. It's getting dusty over there. But what I played, if you didn't understand, I played the main campaign, which has, I don't know, 30 missions spread over 3 acts. And I played this one, the first act, the first 4 missions. Yeah, I liked the campaign. As I said, I played them to death, especially the first 2. The Asian dynasties, I liked it, but doesn't really have a story, a continuous story like these things have, right? No, bye-bye, good luck with the challenges. I mean, good luck, you just have to be persistent. Alright, that's huge. And actually, at every 5 challenges that you unlock, you will receive an icon. Let's see the last challenge. Nah. On the Alaska. Yeah, so you can set up basically a skirmish versus the Russians, and for this one you have to complete the game or just kill the Russians if you have many more. I do like the pistoleros, and they gave them some cool abilities in the US civilization. Revolt to Mexico. Revolt to Mexico. Oh, they got some. I didn't play multiplayer, just skirmish. A bit of skirmish when I checked out Sweden and Incas, stuff like that. Now, thanks for watching, guys. That's it. Bye bye.